This is a Toastmaster box fan. I'm presuming it's from like the 1950s, late 50s, most likely like 57 or something like that. In any event, this is indeed a Toastmaster. Of course, this camera's going to get all blurry once I get in for the close shot, so please bear with me on this one. And, it is a reversible fan. And of course, it's all blurry. Trust me, it says reversible fan underneath the big word that says Toastmaster on it. Right below it, it says model number 5326, 115 volts, 60 cycles AC, 1.6 amps. Toastmaster, division McGraw-Edison Company, Elgin, Illinois. And it is a two-speed reversible fan, as if you can actually see the controls here. But intake and exhaust, low, high, off, high, low. Pretty much explains everything. This has been in my family since I don't know how long. Certainly before I was born, most likely. And surprisingly, it still works. I recently got it down from the attic and gave it a jolly good clean because this thing was filthy. Dirty. Ugh. In any event, so I got it cleaned up as best I can to make it presentable for you people out here on YouTube. And that's pretty nice. The grill is still in pretty decent shape. You can tell it's a three-bladed fan with the nice round blades. Let's get behind it so I can show you my rug. No. There's the engine intake or the motor. Nice heavy-duty bars there holding everything up. In any event, handle, all that. Handle, yes, this is a... This weighs, I swear to God, about maybe 10 plus pounds. It is a really heavy fan. It hasn't been, I haven't had much work done on it at all. I mean, aside from the cleaning it up. So let's power it up and let's show you how it goes on, let's start with low first. Low on blowing towards me, which I guess is going to be, what, exhaust or intake? Probably intake. So let's start with low. Now don't let this fool you. It is actually a quite noisy fan once it starts getting up to speed. Well, that's low, but it's a fake low because this thing hasn't really been run for a long period of time. I just ran it for about a half hour or so beforehand, so you can probably tell it's still getting up to speed. Let's hit it in a high. Yes, this is quite noisy, but it does pump out a lot of air. Let's hit it down to off again. Let it spin down. It takes a little bit to spin down. It's not like the most loose motor in the world, but it's sufficient, I would imagine. And of course, spinning the other way. It's on high. Turn it down to low. And finally off. Let it spin down a bit. So yes, it is reversible. It works both ways. It's quite nice actually. Now I know it's something else that people who like to watch these appliances, old-time appliances, really like to do is hear the spin-up noise that this thing would make. So let me get nice and close here to the back. And let me hit it on, I guess, intake. So here's the motor and we're going to start it up on intake now. it's on high. It does make quite a bit of noise. It's, as I said, this has been in my family for, I want to say about 40, 50 years or so at the very least. Heck, if this fan is from 57 or somewhere thereabouts, what little information I found on the web is about from 1957, and it talks about a Toastmaster box fan model 5326, so there you have it. It's a Toastmaster three-bladed box fan. Any other questions, let me know. I'll try to answer as best I can. Thanks for watching.